Aloha, I'm Doug Harper, the Executive Director of Malama Monolua, and I want to take just a couple moments to share with you the results of our internship program. This summer, Malama Monolua was blessed to have an incredible group of interns. We were initially concerned, given COVID, that we would have to cancel the program, but after reviewing the guidelines, speaking with the interns, and speaking with staff, we modified the program to accommodate the new environment we found ourselves in. I'm extremely proud of the adaptability and perseverance shown by our staff, who were able to continue working on their regular projects while modifying the internship program. I also want to thank the interns for their incredible work and their understanding and flexibility. Let me allow the interns to introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Annalise Zimmer.
My name is Davis Coffey.
My name is Leah Wong.
My name is Sammy Kuriyama.
My name is Nick Nonnenmacher.
They all provided amazing work and enjoyed themselves along the way. These are some of the snippets of what they found.
There were only two gauges in the region contributing to the rainfall atlas before the project began, both privately owned. The installation of more gauges will provide more accurate data for measuring and modeling runoff, varying rainfall, and climate change, and can help the community around Monolulu Bay for decades to come.
A lot of time working with seagrass this summer. My project was all about investigating techniques to facilitate the restoration of the endemic seagrass, Helophilia hawaiiana. Like any seagrass, it supports biodiversity and helps provide habitat space for sea creatures.
Our project explored the potential of installing oyster cages in ideal locations within the marina. We focused on using Pacific oysters since they are natural filter feeders and they're able to consume nutrients in the water, filter out particles and toxins, and release cleaner water back into the system.
This summer, I've been working on the site selection process for a climate-resilient coral reef restoration project in Monolua Bay. I identified the ideal ranges within the data for coral restoration. In this example, using temperature data, as you can see, cooler waters received a higher score because cooler water is more suitable for coral survival under climate change conditions. And finally, I identified suitable sites for coral restoration. This map shows the summation of the scores from each of the data layers in the weighted analysis. And this is my final scored map.
Mahalo to all the interns this summer, to our funders, especially the Atherton Family Foundation, our supporters and partners, and to everyone who helped make the program a success. I especially want to thank and call out our incredible staff, who in addition to continuing the suite of projects to restore the health of Monolua Bay, were able to mentor and guide the interns in their work. Stay safe, everyone, and mahalo nui loa.